You ever wake up and just wonder why? Why am I here? Why am I doing these push-ups? Why did I even get out of bed this morning? What is the point of all of this? Does what I do even matter? I ask myself this every day, and I still have yet to find a decent answer.
Sanctity and the theme of Anthony's little diner. I mean, yeah, the theme, you know? Like, okay, this is what we're gonna do. See, we're using this thing called Clorox Rain Shower. And it's got this minty freshness to it. See, you'll learn one day that along with the grade A American food that comes here, you know, it goes with the music, the king, the crickets, it's got all that atmosphere. But what they want is they want to smell in the nostrils. They want the tables to reek of that minty freshness, you know? And I just read in Newsweek, you know, that 80% of the people that sit at a clean table will eat and eat and eat more and more food, which means what? More income for the rest of them, right?
Right.
Okay? So we're gonna use some Clorox Rain Shower, not this crap.
That's probably the most ridiculous thing I've ever heard.
You got fired? What happened?
I don't know.
You don't know? What do you mean you don't know? Daddy worked really hard to get you this job. I mean, and it's bad enough all the things I have to hear about you from my parents. But you can help me out, you know? I try so hard to support you, and then you go and you get fired? You can't just mess around anymore. What am I supposed to do if I have a fiance that can't support me? I mean, the wedding is coming up, I'm starting to get stressed out.
Jenny, never mind.
Never mind what? If you have something to say to me, say it, because
I sit here, listening to my fiance scold me like a dog or like a mother would to her 5-year-old child just spilled cranberry juice on her new white carpet. Does that even happen in real life? I don't know. I don't even understand what she's saying most of the time. Some sort of ancient gibberish that man has long since forgotten. You've got to be a code breaker to talk to her or something. She needs to write her own language book for... What the hell?
How? I have this light in my face and you're not even paying attention to me. You are the worst fiancé ever. Okay. Are you even listening to a word I've said? How do I know that you're going to commit to me in this marriage that is so rapidly approaching when you cannot commit?
All I know is one thing. My dad got you. I can't take this anymore.
Where are you going?
I don't know. To get a job, maybe? Because we all know that your dad can't have his daughter marrying some freeloader.
That's not funny. Look, they went to Europe for the weekend. I thought we could just have a weekend, you know, just us. Plus, we need to talk about some of the wedding arrangements. One of the big things is flower arrangements. I want lilies and my mom wants orchids, and we've just been having it out these past couple weeks. So, the question is, lilies or orchids? Also, Daddy is catering in Italian. The jazz band and the DJ have already been picked out. And Daddy is just insistent on having Merlot as a choice of wine for the guests. Personally, I think Zinfandel is the better choice. I'm thinking of having an intimate ceremony, no more than 200 in attendance, and then a big ceremony by the lakeshore. Then, of course, Daddy said he would take care of both the honeymoon and housing arrangement, and Mom is simply ecstatic to meet your parents. I didn't tell them about your adoption, though, so you might want to call your parents and let them know ahead of time, so we're all on the same page, okay?
Yeah, okay, I'll...
But what about...
Whatever you want to do about the flowers, I don't care. I'm going to go now, though. Okay.
Wait, you're still leaving? What about the weekend? What about the wedding arrangements?
It sounds like you've got everything under control. Plus, I'm tired. So, I'll talk to you later.
Okay, then. I love you.
You too.
Two days straight driving. In those 2 days, I've spent nearly all of my money on gas, traveled halfway across the country, slept maybe a total of 5 hours in the back seat of my shitty car, and Jennifer has called me a grand total of 10 times in a 2-day span. I haven't even bothered to check the messages. Two days driving, guys gotta eat. What the hell?
Just drive!
Drive? Get the hell out of my car! What are you talking about?
Look, I'll give you $2,000. Just drive right now. Let's just go. Thanks a lot back there.
What was that back there? A freaking serial killer or something?
Just calm down, Slick.
My God. You're not gonna kill me, are you?
Pa, I'm not gonna kill you. You're my chauffeur. You want some gum?
What's your problem?
What?
You can't just hijack someone's car.
Yes, you can. It happens all the time. My name's Marie, by the way. So, what's yours? You gonna make me guess? Paul? Thomas? Casey?
Jim. My name's Jim. So, where am I going?
You are taking me to Mexico.
What's in Mexico?
Paradise.
No, you're a really cryptic person. I don't care for those kind of people very much. Why do you gotta be by Mexico?
Look, all you need to be concerned about is just getting me there, and then I'll give you the $2,000. And, hell, maybe after all this is through, we could be best buds.
All my life, I've done what others have told me to do, and today is no exception. And yet, it is. In some perverse way, it is.
So what's her name?
Excuse me?
Girlfriend? Wife? Sister?
Fiance. Her name's Jenny.
Jimmy and Jenny. That's a kicker.
I guess it is. Never really thought about it like that, though.
How long have you guys been seeing each other?
Since high school. I mean, a few years, at least.
She must really love you.
Yeah. She does. Here, I have a picture of her.
Fate has an odd way of playing games on us.
Have you ever been in love?
I don't know. Maybe once or twice.
What do you mean?
I mean, how do you really know what love is? I mean, there are couples that have been together for years, and by society's standards, they're perfect for each other. But really, there's nothing there. It's like a wine glass, you know? It's so pretty, but when there's nothing inside, there's really no use for it. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I think I do. Hijack my car and take me to Mexico?
Okay. Nice attempt, Slick, but we're going to have to definitely work on your insult skills.
But seriously, though, what kind of music do you like?
It's all about the classic rock for me.
Well, at least you didn't say rap.
What, you don't like rap?
I can't understand what they're saying half the time.
It's great dance music, though. Have you ever danced to it? Person are you?
I just never learned, okay?
You never went with your girlfriend?
She never really wanted to dance with me.
Why?
I don't know. I think I embarrass her. I think I always embarrass her. But she always wants me to be somebody who I'm not. It seems like no matter what I do, it's never gonna be enough, you know?
Is that why you ran away?
I guess. I mean, at the time, I just couldn't stop driving.
And now?
Now, I guess. Well, who can really define love anyway?
My feelings
exactly.
Oh my god, I love this song!
In the misty moonlight.
Pull a car over!
What?
Oh, just pull a car over!
Firelight.
We're in the middle of nowhere.
Any place is
well,
all
that's
right.
Even more of a reason. Just pull the car over!
She can't be serious.
You want to learn how to dance, don't you? Now I just have to teach you how to salsa.
Arriba.
Ooh, I have to pee really, really bad.
And now?
Yeah, pull the car over, please.
This just in. New Mexico authorities are currently on the lookout for a young Caucasian woman reported to be in early 20s. She's been charged by New Mexico officials as illegally tampering with local casino slot machines. Authorities report she may be the famed casino con who has been responsible for multiple casino money laundering events in Nevada and Arizona. She was last seen in a gas station near the New Mexico-Arizona border region and, according to eyewitness accounts, was traveling with another person. If you have any information regarding this subject, you are to notify the authorities at once.
Were you ever going to tell me about it?
I just didn't want to freak you out.
Yeah, well, you failed. You're on the freaking radio, Marie. And they know that I'm with you. Talk about getting freaked out. Yeah, it's pretty scary. So, you just... What, you just needed me to get you to Mexico and that was it? And you were just gonna feed me to the dogs and leave me there? Deal with the cost myself? But that's right, I forgot. You'd be in paradise. And I'd be sitting in some Mexican jail somewhere, not being able to talk to anybody, and you would be out sitting on some Mexican island, sipping your Coronas and eating shrimp cocktail. Am I right?
Yeah, you're right.
What the hell is your problem? Is that how your life is? Is that what you do? You just go town from town, stealing, using people, abusing? You don't care about anybody else but yourself.
Yeah, well, you should know all about that yourself, right, Jimmy?
What the hell are you talking about?
Don't tell me you drove halfway across the U.S. just to get away from your happy life with your boring girlfriend? Don't, no. You're just as selfish as I am.
You're freaking insane.
I guess I am. But then why are we still here? Why didn't you take off right after you heard all that stuff on the radio? Hmm? Okay. Right about everything you said. I did just want you as my chauffeur. And I did want them to catch you. That's what I was going for. But not anymore. I didn't think I would end up liking you.
Jennifer.
Okay, look, Jim, I know I really screwed you over, but we're only 100 miles away from the border, and when we get there, I know people that can get us across the border, no problems. And then we'd be there. Paradise.
Ever wake up one morning and just ask why? I did that all the time. Just going through the motions and never truly grasping why. I lived in a little shell, never having the need. No, the want to break out of it.
Do they have any dance clubs in Mexico?
And then I met Marie. So, do I still get my money?